On Sunday, I went out to the Sikh temple at Tak Nini and addressed an audience which would have been in excess of 3,000 people. They were gathered there for their normal Sunday service, but also to commemorate the life of Navtesh Singh, who had been shot dead in his liquor store about a week earlier. Navtesh Singh is one of a number of New Zealanders that have died in the last 9 days now in South Auckland. It reflects a growing climate of violent crime, an inability, it seems, on our society's part to find solutions to very difficult problems, and I think an inability from this government to really tackle the big issues that matter when it comes to crime. The State of the Nation speech, I talked about how we could have camps for young people, where there would be correction camps, young people learning discipline and respect and boundaries, also dealing with their drug and alcohol issues and literacy and numeracy, followed on by mentoring programs. Two or three weeks ago, the New Zealand Herald ran a story about a man called Steve Boxer who's running those kinds of courses in Auckland. He's been highly successful, but is unsure about whether he'll get funding from Child, Youth and Family. He's one of a number of providers around the country that doesn't know whether they'll get any more funding, but certainly looks like they won't get enough to be able to carry on their businesses and to carry on the courses that have been making such a big difference. National and government will have different priorities. We think it's far more important that these young people are run through these correction camps, that we have a greater attempt to try and help those people and resolve the issues that those young New Zealanders face before they really go off the rails. There are 1,000 of them, as the Chief Youth Court Judge Andrew Beecroft described, as unexploded human time bombs. Unless we're prepared to take a more proactive stance, those people are going to go on, commit very serious and heinous crimes in our society, and we will be all the worse for it. But it's not just youth camps. There's also a need for greater police on the street, and I think greater police numbers where they're focused actually on, you know, a physical presence on the streets. It's one thing to just hire more police officers, it's another to have them focused in the areas that matter. Interestingly enough, today I noted in the House that in Manukau City, they still have the second to lowest number of police officers per head of population. And there's more in the area of law and order. There's issues in relation to rewriting the bail and parole laws, which have become too lax under this Labor government, about correcting the imbalance between victims and criminals in our society. And we'll have a lot more to say about sentencing and other matters. And of course there's that issue of drugs. National is very happy to look at, and in fact we're proposing a cross-party select committee to look at the whole issues around the sale of liquor, around alcohol, and about what we can do about our binge drinking community and binge drinking culture that we have operating in our society. But I was surprised when the Prime Minister raised on Monday that she was looking to have officials do some more work. Surprised not because she couldn't see it's a big issue, but because in November of 2006, after Parliament had voted down the ability to raise the drinking age, she commissioned her then Minister of Justice, Mark Burton, and Associate Minister of Health, Damien O'Connor, to go and do just that work. They reported back a year later, and yet nothing has changed. We've had 9 years of the Labor government, 9 years when there's been too many pilot schemes, too many official reviews, too many reports, too many people looking into problems, and not enough action. And if I can make just this promise to you, it will be this one, that National's going to stop all the navel-gazing in office. I'm going to get on and tackle some of the hard problems, do it with some urgency, do it with a plan, and actually make a difference. We've had nearly a decade now of a government that's been constantly looking to write more reports and to consider other alternatives, but actually made very few changes that have they've demonstrated any real change. And that's why violent crime is up 43% across our country and over 60% in South Auckland. We're going to do something about it. I just want to note a couple of other things. The Facebook site, now nearly 4,400 people have come on the site. Thank you very much. It's great to have you as friends. And if you can recommend other friends to become friends, that'll be great too, because we'd like to build those numbers and build that network. That's fantastic. And for those of you that are leaving messages on the site, I am seeing them, and I just want to reflect on one or two. Mark Donaldson, who I had lunch with a bunch of other very exciting entrepreneurs, emailed me or left a message on the site in relation to vision for New Zealand. Mark, I know you and I are on the same page when it comes to that. Just on crime, it's been a really hot issue on the site. We've seen some interesting ones from Noodleson. Fortunately, a fake name, Noodle. I'm glad with that. But really talking about how we can make things better and improve life in Manurewa. And Jacob Taros, he wrote to me about how crime is really out of control. And on the cost of living, that's been really the other big hot issue. We've seen petrol prices rising rapidly. We've seen food prices rising across the board. New Zealanders increasingly finding it difficult to make ends meet. Michael Song, Nick Donald, and Maui Cooper all wrote in relation to that topic, and it was great to hear from you all. So thanks for watching the site. Thanks for posting your comments and leaving your wishes on the site. And I look forward to communicating with you sometime real soon.